Part 2. Everything starts with you. I hope you have done the exercise in part 1. Thank you for continuing to listen to part 2. Dear friends, I think each one of us is a center of the world, meaning everything starts with you, me, and others. We often think the world is affecting us, but how many of us are thinking we are also affecting the world? Because everything starts with us. Anything we have done and are doing, such as producing, consuming, and throwing away, has an impact on ourselves, on others, and on the world around us, and even on the world beyond us, whether we are aware of it or not. Our impacts can be good or bad. It can be big or small, noticeable or unnoticeable. It can be life-giving or destructive. The more we are aware of our impacts, the better we know what to do or how to continue what we are doing. Dear friends, I bet you have made some good impacts on yourselves, on others, and on the world in one way or another. People may notice and acknowledge you. If they don't, please don't stop. Are you doing it to let people know? Or are you doing it for the sake of goodness? If you have tried and have failed, don't give up. Stop and think, how can I do better? Or why is it not working? Do you agree that the real world is much bigger than what you know? There will be something or someone you don't know or are not aware of. There will be something mysterious or unknown. These can be your starting points of expanding your world. The tools you need are there and available, including Google and social media. However, don't just look at your phone or your computer, but go out there and see the world for yourselves. You should learn what your blind spots are. You should talk to people and learn from them. Try to put aside your bias or your judgment. Be curious and open while listening to their stories and actions. I bet you will learn a lot. Are you ignoring the world's problems? Why? Are you sure those problems will never affect you? So be open to know what the world's problems are and learn how people handle it. Because someday, it may be helpful to you when the world's problems arrive at your door. Do you believe that you can do everything? Are you sure? I think you should know that you cannot and will never be able to do everything. But you can certainly make some good impacts for others and for the world according to your ability and intelligence. The question is, are you willing to do it? If you are willing to make a good impact today, what do you want to do? Don't give up if you fail, my dear friends. End of part 2.